Hi viewers, welcome to my YouTube channel. Let's start the discussion with a statement by Martin Luther King Jr. If we are to have peace on earth, our loyalties must transcend our race, our tribe, our class, and our nation. And this means we must develop a world perspective in our everyday living. But today I have taken for a discussion Pablo Neruda's, one of the most famous poem, Keeping Quiet. Pablo Neruda, a poet, great poet from Chile, who has won the Nobel Prize in the year 1971. Here where, you know, the poet makes the readers introspect, put on hold everything and try to analyze, realize the accomplishments, achievements what they have done, instead of moving further in the mad rush behind the materialistic wealth and all. Let us see in the Keeping Quiet poem what the poet has to say. For the readers, we have the poem Keeping Quiet by Pablo Neruda, an individual in the nature. That's what I am highlighting. The first stanza. Now we will count to 12 and we will all keep still for once on the face of the earth. The poet is very sure what he is trying to tell. Now we will count to 12. 1 to 12. It can be 12 months, it can be 12 hours a day. The poet is meaning, and we will all keep still. We will, the poet is addressing to all the human beings. We will all keep still for once. Keep still. Well, let us introspect. Let us put on hold whatever we are doing completely and rest for a while. Once on the face of the earth. So man and earth, the poet is meaning to all the human beings. Let us not speak in any language. Very interesting. The poet is trying to tell that language can be a barrier. A language can be a watertight compartment where we may not be able to express ourselves. So the poet is trying to mean to all the human beings. Let us not speak in any language. He is addressing to all the people of all religions, all languages, the entire people on earth. Let us stop for a second and not move our arms so much. So even our arms, it can be our arms as well as the weapons. The poet is meaning that he is addressing to all the human beings to keep quiet. Let us be still for once, for a moment, and let us put on hold whatever we are doing. All our activities, let us stop for a moment on this earth. For the second stanza, it would be an exotic moment, very interesting moment in our life. For the first time, the poet addressing to the readers, and as a reader, as a human being, we are putting on hold everything, stand still. It seems to be entirely different, adventurous moment, the poet is telling. Exotic moment, something extraordinary. Why? Without rush, the mad rush of the modern world, modern man, behind materialistic wealth. Okay, let us put on hold everything, whatever we are doing. Running behind the money, running behind the materialistic wealth, without rush, mad rush, without engines, the vehicles, the engine of our life, everyday, hard struggle of life, everything will put on hold. We would all be together in a sudden strangeness. So this exotic moment where the moment, you know, the poet is addressing all the, we will keep quiet, and the moment of keeping quiet will bring all the human beings of all religions together on a common platform, all be together for a moment. Sudden strangeness, something new, something, a peaceful moment has been achieved according to Pablo Neruda. It is entirely a different way of approach the poet is highlighting here. Further, you know, with some examples the poet tries to highlight. Fishermen in the cold sea would not harm whales. So some example, fishermen and whales, whale being a commodity commercially being killed and all, even let them put on hold whatever they are doing for a moment. So indirectly the poet is giving an instruction to all those people, let us not harm the environment, let us not harm the animals, that part. The man gathering salt would not look at his hurt hands. Even the man who is gathering the salt, for a moment, let him also stop whatever he is doing. So the poet is asking all the human beings belong to all religions to keep quiet and count to 12, and holding all our activities for a moment, introspect. Let us stop whatever we are doing, this mad rush, behind, running behind money, running behind materialistic wealth, whatever we are doing, a fisherman killing the whales, a salt gatherer gathering the salt, everything, whatever we are doing, let us put on hold everything. Pablo Neruda is addressing to all the human beings. even languages also, let us keep quiet for a moment and let's try to introspect. Let us try to analyze whatever we have achieved, accomplished so far, and let us try to enjoy a bit, a moment in our life. That's what the poet is highlighting here. Further in the next stanza, Pablo Neruda continue the thought that, you know, keeping quiet and addressing the fishermen as well as the salt gatherers, he further gives some more instances. Those who prepare green wars, okay, fighting deforestation and all that, wars with gas, okay, the war with poisonous gas and atom bomb, nuclear bombs and all that, wars with fire, victories with no survivors, would put on clean clothes. So the war, now the poet is addressing to all those human beings, all those countries who are waging wars, wars with fire, ammunitions, the modern weapons, victories with no survivors. So for Pablo Neruda, war is nothing but victories with no survivors. It is almost like, so war can bring no happiness. War will not never bring peace, but it will be war. It is almost like a victory with no survivors, ultimately death. And so let us stop, put on hold everything, and let's keep quiet. Would put on clean. So the poet is addressing to all those people, would put on clean clothes and walk about with their brothers in the shade doing nothing. With their brothers. So it is almost like a world peace, universal brotherhood, the poet Pablo Neruda is trying to highlight in keeping quiet. So the poet is telling, for a moment, he is addressing all the people of all languages, the entire world, walk about with their brothers in the shade for a moment. Let us stop whatever we are doing and let us introspect what we have achieved, what we have done. So let us analyze, let us put on hold everything. Brothers in the shade doing nothing. So doing nothing, the poet is trying to tell, keep quiet, let us keep quiet and let us not spoil the environment, let us not kill the animals, and let us even stop the wars for a moment. And let us think in a different way. Let us have a different strategy what we are doing. Let us stop that mad rush, the poet is highlighting further. What I want should not be confused with the total inactivity. So the poet is very clear here. So the inactivity is, the poet is addressing to all the human beings, you know, stop war, the destruction, which will be, the war cannot bring peace. War can be only destruction, and even the environment, the human lives are being lost. So the poet expects the entire world to put on hold, keep quiet, count 1 to 12, and let us stop for a moment and let us just introspect. Let us see what we have achieved, what we have gained by doing all that mad rush, running behind money and materialistic wealth. Let us put on hold everything. This is what the poet is highlighting here. The poet is highlighting his thoughts should not be confused with inactivity. The poet is addressing all the human beings to put on hold, keep quiet, count 1 to 12. Further, the poet almost now in the final last stanza seems to be summing up what he intends to tell. Life is what it is about. So we need to ponder for a moment. Let us relax a bit. Instead of running behind that mad rush of materialistic wealth and money, let us start thinking unitedly to have some different strategies for a moment. From this stage onwards, the poet seems to be giving us the solution part. If we were not so single-minded about keeping our lives moving, so moving further, forward, okay, only with a selfish greediness, let us think about it, the poet is trying to tell. If we were not so single-minded, instead of running behind, you know, mad rush of materialistic wealth and money, you know, worrying more about our own achievements, keeping our lives moving, keeping our lives happiness about our own individual lives, we need to think beyond that. What is that? And for once, could do nothing, keeping quiet, still, not doing anything, perhaps a huge silence might interrupt this sadness of never understanding ourselves. Very interesting. Now, the poet seems to be giving a very clear message here. and for once could do nothing. So the concept of keeping quiet, not doing running behind the mad rush, once could do nothing, perhaps a huge silence, being still, holding all our horses, running behind the materialistic wealth, the silence might interrupt this sadness of never understanding ourselves. So the poet wants all the human beings to analyze our actions, our achievements for a moment, and of threatening ourselves with death. See the concept of death. Human beings are having that parameter of death, which is forcing them to run behind, almost on a daily basis, to run behind the money and the materialistic wealth. The poet expects the readers, all the human lives, to put on hold everything, keep quiet. Now I will count up to 12 and you keep quiet and I will go. So finally the repetition, the refrain of the thought of the first para, what is that? I will count up to 12 and keep quiet. Same thing, I will count up to 12 and you will keep quiet and I will go. So the poet has given us his views how to have a different strategy in whatever work we are doing, whatever activities we are doing, to put on hold instead of polluting the environment, instead of killing the human lives. Let us think of peaceful means, some sort of world peace, common brotherhood, universal brotherhood, where we can have a different strategy in achieving the best. Let us think beyond that death. Let us think beyond of keeping our own lives moving. Instead of that, let us all put on hold everything and let us collectively start thinking, analyzing what we are doing. Are we doing, are we going in the right path or what? So this is the very interesting thought the poet tries to highlight. And the concept of universal brotherhood and the peace, I just highlighted with pictures. Finally, in the last stanza, Pablo Neruda is trying to give us in the poem Keeping Quiet, one of the very important theme which has made him to come out to this perspective entirely. What is this? Let's see. Life is what it is about. The poet is reiterating, giving us a very important thought. What is that? Perhaps the earth can teach us as when everything seems dead. So the concept of winter season, where the trees will shed its leaves, and that part is being highlighted and later proves to be alive. The spring season, in the winter season, the trees are shedding the leaves and it is almost like, you know, it is welcoming the spring season, where later proves to be alive. So the poet expects the readers to look at nature and in times of crisis moments, like keeping quiet, putting on hold, it is almost like, you know, everything seems dead. It is a freezing moment in the nature. So we have to look at the nature, and nature is teaching us freezing. So in our life also, we need to freeze ourselves, keeping quiet, silence. Silently, you know, everything seems dead in nature, but it is not dead. What is that? Later proves to be alive in the spring season. So like in nature, the trees shedding its leaves and coming back alive in the spring season, we also in our life, we need to pause for a moment, ponder over our own actions, our own achievements, accomplishments, and then we have to think once again, our soul coming back alive, like the trees, which is, seems to be dead in winter and later spring, alive. Our soul has to come back to life, and that is where the purpose of life, the poet in this poem, Keeping Quiet, Pablo Neruda is making us to understand. So it is a direct statement. Through nature, man has to analyze, we have to contemplate, we have to rethink, and we have to make our life really meaningful, understanding the purpose of life, and where we need to think in a very positive manner, looking into the constructive ways of analyzing our own actions in life. That is very meaningful here. Finally, to conclude Pablo Neruda's Keeping Quiet poem, I have compiled a few key points here. The entire poem is nothing but introspection as well as a retrospection of our actions. All the human beings and our actions is being highlighted. The poet also tries to focus on the world peace, the common brotherhood, as well as the unity, peace among all the human beings, devoid of all the languages, language barriers, and all the inhibitions. Okay, further, the concept of the title, Keeping Quiet. It is almost like a refrain, and it's a very interesting theme. What is that? Where through silence, the poet expects the readers, all the human beings, to achieve something extraordinary. What is that? To relive our own accomplishments, to relive our own accomplishments and put on hold everything and try to analyze, retrospect, as well as to introspect our own actions and accomplishments. So the concept of silence is being highlighted here. For a moment, in our mad rush running behind the money as well as the materialistic wealth, the poet expects all the readers to put on hold everything and keep quiet. Further, the poet gives us two images, fishermen killing the whales as well as the salt gatherers hurting their own hands, plus no arms, the concept of weapons to put on hold, even the war, engaging human beings or the different nations engaging in war. The poet expects them to put on hold and start thinking of new strategies instead of war. War will not bring anything peaceful. War will bring only death and destructions. So fishermen, salt gatherers, as well as the human beings who are using the arms, weapons, and even no engines. Okay, let us all move away from our greediness, running behind the mad rush of money as well as materialistic wealth. So the poet is highlighting on the concept of keeping quiet is nothing but keep calm, the silence, keeping calm, and let us understand the purpose of our human life on this earth. And here the poet starts giving us the concept of nature here. When we become one with nature, we will be at peace. That is being highlighted. So in the journey of our everyday living, the poet is trying to analyze that. Let us look at nature, and the concept of winter as well as spring season is being highlighted. Winter is almost like a freezing moment where all the trees will shed the leaves, and it will prepare itself for the spring, where the rebirth of the soul. Similarly, the poet expects keeping quiet, and let us have a different strategy. Let us introspect all our actions, and let us try to analyze peaceful ways of approach to our life and living. And that's what the poet is trying to tell. Let us look at nature and let us introspect and let us stop whatever we are doing. Keeping quiet becomes a symbol of silence to relive our own accomplishments and whatever we achieved so far, and to take a breathing space in our everyday living and life. And that's what the poet Pablo Neruda in Keeping Quiet makes us to look back at our own life and living, and instead of this mad rush behind the money as well as materialistic wealth, let us put on hold our language barriers, our inhibitions, everything. Let us try to analyze and once again retrospect, and whatever we are doing, let us keep quiet and let us think, looking at nature. Let us take clues from the nature and relive our own life. The death, of course, with the death, man always is running away from death, trying to achieve, accomplish day and night. So the poet is telling, let us put on hold everything and looking at nature, let us try to, let us become one with nature. And through nature, the winter and spring concept, let us try to analyze our own actions, and through our accomplishments, try to bring in the concept of world peace, common brotherhood and unity and peaceful ways. Deforestation and all, let us not try to pollute the nature as such. Let us look after the nature as well as the common brotherhood, and let us try to live peacefully. That's what the poet is all trying to highlight here in the poem Keeping Quiet. Consider to like and subscribe.